Easy Home Studio or even YouTube Studio set up in under 5 minutes. Let's go. First of all, the lights. The most important light of it is the key light, which is basically set up to my left side. Some tips for your key light. For your key light to be most effective, it's pretty important to keep your key light close to your face. This creates, in my opinion, the best light. Once it's close enough to your face, it's pretty important to set up your light properly so it doesn't overexpose your face or underexpose your face. Let's go over to the next light, which is the fill light. To my right hand side, there is a blue LED panel, which is basically acting as my fill light. You can also use like a reflector, which is basically bouncing your key light back towards the other side of your face. Or you can use like a mini LED light or even like a LED panel like I'm doing. Then you can also go really crazy and use some hair light to light up your hair. But I don't use that, so I'm not talking about that one right here, because I like to talk about things I'm using and I know about, and I don't know that much about hair lights. And I think for an easy YouTube studio setup, those two lights will do just fine. Let's move on to the practical lights, which are basically this orange light behind me and this blue LED panel on my right hand side. These are basically lights which add some atmosphere to the scene and which help you to create more depth in your scene. Basically, if the light wasn't even on, this scene would not look more flat, basically. But for your practical lights to be effective, it's pretty important to choose the right perspective. What I mean by that is, if you place them too far behind, they get too far out of focus and you can't even see them. But if you place them too close to you, then it's pretty hard to even separate yourself from the background, if you know what I mean. I like to keep it in the middle so I can just see my background. I know that on my right hand side is the camera and back there is the lamp and everything else. I can still see what it is, but it's still out of focus and it still creates enough depth from me towards the background. Then you obviously need a camera or a phone to film yourself. I'm using the Sony a7 III with the Tamron 17-28mm 2.8, but you can also use just your phone. This will do just fine, because lighting and perspective are way more important than your camera. If you're using a camera, I would highly suggest you to keep the f-stop as low as possible to create even more depth in your scene. This lens goes to 2.8, so I'm using 2.8 right now, basically. Now let's move on to the audio. You can use like on-camera microphones like I have on my camera, but you can also use like these microphones, which are XLR microphones, which I personally like more because they have better audio quality. But with XLR microphones, you have to sync them in post, which is not a big deal if you're using two microphones, but if you're just using one, it can be quite hard. So just keep that in mind. I can make a whole video about that too if you want to. Just leave it down in the comment section below. And if you don't have any microphones at all, that's okay too. Just use the internal microphone of your phone, for example. And I also have a bonus tip for you. Don't overthink all that. It's pretty easy to overthink all of your gear and of your setup and everything, basically, and to forget that you have to record a video. Just record the video. It doesn't matter if the lighting is perfect or if like the audio is perfect and if your key light is set up properly. That doesn't matter at all. Just do your video. These are just tips which may help you get a more atmospheric scene in your video. In your videos. Oh yeah. So yeah, that's it. I hope you found this helpful. If so, leave your feedback down in the comment section below. This helps me out a lot, as always. Also, make sure to leave a like on the video if you liked it. And subscribe to the channel if you're new here. And turn on bell notifications so you don't miss any video in the future. And also follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook. I think I forgot something. I don't care. But also make sure to follow me there. And if you're interested in checking out the products I used in this video, I'm not affiliated with any of them, so this is not a sponsored video. But I have some Amazon links down below if you want to check them out. So yeah, that's it. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.